Hello, this is Pastor David Charlton with my daily devotion for March the 28th, 2020. We're finishing out the week, and as we've done every day this week, we're following Martin Luther's daily prayer pattern from the Small Catechism. So we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let's say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Then we continue with Luther's morning prayer. We give you thanks, Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have protected us through the night from all danger and harm. We ask you to preserve and keep us this day also from all sin and evil, that in all our thoughts, words, and deeds we may serve and please you. Into your hands we commend our bodies and souls, and all that is ours. Let your holy angels have charge of us, that the wicked one have no power over us. Amen. I've chosen another one of my personal favorites for the hymn today. It's the first hymn I ever remember singing. I was sitting at Trinity Lutheran Church in Kissimmee, Florida, on my dad's lap, and everyone in the church was on metal folding chairs, and there was a terrazzo floor. And this is the first hymn I remember ever singing. I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story because I know it's true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else would do. I love to tell the story. I'll sing this theme in glory and tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. I'll let that be enough for today, but we'll hit that theme as we go into our devotion. So one of the daily readings for today from the Revised Common Lectionary comes from Luke chapter 24. Then Jesus said to his disciples, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Luke 24, verses 44 to 49. One of the things that characterizes the Christian faith is our conviction that no matter what is going on in our lives, in history, in the world, Scripture is the surest way to make sense of things and to find a path forward. In our Bible verse today, Jesus is talking to his disciples on Easter evening. They're still in shock over all the things that have happened. In only 3 days, he was brutally executed, only to rise again. They could hardly take it all in. Jesus tells them how to make sense of what happened. He says, "Everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then Luke goes on to say, "He opened their minds to understand the scriptures." Now, when Jesus speaks of the law, the prophets, and the Psalms, he is referring to what we today call the Old Testament. It was all there in Scripture. The New Testament, obviously, had not yet been written. To make sense of our own day and what God is doing in our world, we should also turn to the same place, to the Scriptures. Now, what does this mean? Some people will jump to the conclusion that Jesus is telling us to search the Scriptures for a prophecy about COVID-19 or Donald Trump or Mario Cuomo or Nancy Pelosi. It's as if the purpose of Scripture is to predict the future. That's what some people think the main purpose of Scripture is. That's not how we in the Lutheran Church understand it, however. What is the key to the Scriptures in our time and in any time? Again, Jesus in our lesson today provides the key. "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Scriptures tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. And that remains the key in our time, just as it is for all times. The key to our history, the key to what is going on in the world, is still the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Our calling is to interpret our own times by telling the old, old story once again. Just next week, we're going to begin to relive that old, old story, beginning with Palm Sunday, going to Maundy, Thursday, and Good Friday, and Easter. And again, we believe this is the key to all history. This is the key to our own future. This is the key to our lives. That's what it means to be a Christian, to believe that in Jesus Christ and his death and resurrection, everything comes together, the past and the future and the present. And it is our calling as Christians to be witnesses to these things. Let us pray. Lord God, we live in confusing times, when the future is uncertain. We look for guidance so that we can understand what to do and what to hope for. Open our minds to understand the Scriptures, that they might help us to tell the old, old story for our own times. Make us witnesses to the death and resurrection of our Lord as the center point of all history and the only true hope for the future. Amen. Thanks for being with me today, and I'll see you tomorrow at 9:30. For our televised worship service. See you then. Bye.